day the Lord has made.
Let it be glory.
Please take out one of the Bibles. If you look at the red books, it says Holy Bible. You can very easily tell which one it is. You can also look at page 850. The Gospel of the Lord is proclaimed by the Holy Evangelist, St. Matthew. And Jesus answered, O faithful, said to the first generation, how long am I to be with you? How long am I to bear with you? Words here to me sound like the words of someone that's getting kind of fed up, kind of getting bored. How long am I supposed to put up with you? How long am I supposed to be with you? Tells me that God has lots of patience. How much patience do you have? This much. You know, if you ever, it's a very important part of that, if you ever go with me to the bank, or if you go with me shopping, please, for your own sake, do not get on the line I get on. I always get on the line with the lady, with the man, that can't find their credit card, doesn't know if it's a debit or a credit card, cannot find their checkbook, doesn't know where their money is. Says, can you hold on while I go and take this back? I want to get something else. And I'm standing there, and we're trying to finish it. When I was living in New Jersey, I went to college in New York City, in Queens, St. John's University. And then maybe that brought me patience than me. Why am I patient? I'll tell you why. Because I got a call the other day from a lady. I don't know who this woman is. Her background is Orthodox, not Antiochian. And she told me that she'd been living here in Central Florida for 7 years. And that she had visited another Orthodox church. She did not like it because it was in a different language. So she began to go to a Protestant church near where she lived. She said, I like the pastor, I like his message, but I feel badly. I miss my home. I miss my Orthodox. I told her about St. George's. She said, well, let me see if I can get there this Sunday. She's not here today. But now, patience. I visited a family recently in White Oak for almost the whole 42 years. And I remember for a long time they didn't come to church. And someone said to me, what are you going to give up on those people? I said, I don't give up on them. And finally, they're in church. Then they stop in the church. They come back to church. Now they're in there. They're not going to church situation. My point is, my friends, that patience is something that we acquire with experience. When I was a child, and many of you do this, when we would advocate my mother, so she'd say, you know, I can't wait for you to have children. So they can do to you what you do to me. I never told my children that. But the closest I ever came to saying that, to one of them, I said, I hope that when you get married, you'll be the most wonderful, kind, considerate, loving children they ever were. They looked at me surprised. I said, because if they're anything like you, they'll drive me crazy. But the closest I came, I have told especially mothers, please do not say these words to your children. Because when you say those words to your children, what you realize is that you're cursing your children. And the only curse right before this power of God's curse is the mother's curse. They said, I don't mean that's what you said. But the joy is that when they have children, they begin to understand. They look at things differently. So if God is patient with us, I'm not God. I try to be patient. But where is your patience? How many of you know people that don't come to church? Matter of fact, it was a chance. He said to me, Father John, you cannot imagine how many people, as I go around living in Orlando, that I meet, and when I tell them I'm from St. George's, they either went to St. George's, they know about St. George's. Some of them tell me, I'm a member of that church. And he says that he thinks we're going to say to them, I've never seen you there. So the patience that we're talking about can wear thin. How many times are we going to say to God, well, I didn't get there because I had this to do or that to do, this came up, that came up. I don't understand it why. Just like I do not understand, I have understanding. You come from all the law and have understanding. I don't know what you're talking about. And you can make all sorts of gestures and I won't know what you're talking about. As a matter of fact, I told the court of Baba once, I speak better Arabic than I understand. I know what I'm saying. I'm not too sure what they're saying. But my point is that sooner or later, you begin to get the idea of what we're talking about here, that people continue to use this, but then something happens. My mother, in 2009, came to liturgy on Palm Sunday. She was looking forward to Pascha. She didn't get to Holy Tuesday. So how long is God going to put up with us, the faithful? Forget the one about the faithful. We're going to the church for all of these ridiculous reasons. And I'll tell you why. You might say, well, they're ridiculous to you, they're not ridiculous to me. I'll tell you why. Because the priorities. Any of you who visit my home know that I have a flagpole outside of my house. church one Sunday, the elevator was not working. He's done that in the past. You know what that woman did? Hand it off. She crawled up those stairs. She crawled up those stairs. She pulled herself up by her arms and crawled up those stairs to get in here for the liturgy.
Protestantism
what was said in the English means, if you ever read the Bible, Jesus said that following him was going to be easy. No. So when you come fast, oh, I forgot, then remember, on the serving of sea, then don't eat. Let it go. There was nothing to eat but not vegetable, so I didn't eat it. She says, oh, you can't miss dinner. I said, really? Watch me. I can miss dinner. I like to miss breakfast, but I can miss dinner. My friend, I don't tell you these things to make you laugh. I don't tell you these things to make you feel bad. I tell you because it's time. How long is God going to continue to put up with people who are non-Christian, non-Orthodox, non-lovers of the Lord, and compared to those who believe? I want to end with this. This week in Syria, the ISIS, they had abducted over 200 Christians. They went to the town, identified the Christians, they took them, you know what happened to them. Nobody abducts us. Nobody keeps us. Nobody forces us. Nobody threatens us. The time will come when we will not be able stop giving yourself. If you love Jesus, bring yourself on time and bring others with you. And I guarantee you that if you bring someone to this church and they become part of this church, they will be truly happy to worship the Lord God. Let us pray to the Lord. Back. have the old backpacks. We can bring them to church. So we have the other people standing there. So that we can shoot them to the homeless people. We should appreciate that. Also, I'd like to remind you not to light candles in the church when there's no one here. They have to be attended for the sake of the meetings. We also ask that there be no texting, emails, calling in the church, and no social talk. We'll get prayer. In Croatian fashion,